to this point in the unit, we've been talking about very, very structured graphs, very clean and organized graphs. Things like chains or rings or grids, hypercubes that have a great deal of structure. And they look very different from the kinds of actual social network graphs that you see in the wild. Regular graphs tend to have little bits of clustering in them and some people who are more sparsely connected to some other cluster. And they start to look a little bit more randomly generated, or at least not generated according to a very simple, straightforward rule. So it's worthwhile to think about some different ways of randomly generating graphs. The classic kind of randomly generated graph that's been studied in the mathematics literature is generated according to what's called the Erdős-Rényi model. So let me say a little bit about that now. We start off, we imagine we have some graph with n nodes, or we have some set of n nodes, and we have some probability p, which we'll call the connectivity probability. And the generation process works like this. We start off by generating a set of n nodes with no edges at all. Then we loop through all possible pairs of nodes, ij, and we connect ij, but we only connect them after we flip a coin that comes up heads with probability p. And if it does come up heads, we connect the pair, otherwise we don't. We can do this for four nodes. So we have to decide whether to connect the first two nodes. So we flip a coin, comes up heads, so we connect them. Now we look at the second pair, this one and this one. That also came up heads. Third pair, this one and this one, also came up heads. Next pair is this one and this one. Tails, no edge. This one and this one, heads. And finally, this one and this one, heads. I think I have a broken coin. But anyway, you get the idea that you end up with a graph with some of the edges included and some of the edges not included. Now, there's lots of interesting mathematical properties that you can derive given the simplicity of this generation process. You can say, well, what should the probability p be so that the graph is very likely to be connected? There's no disconnected nodes floating off into space, or that there's relatively short paths from one node to the next. And so this has been fairly well studied. Researchers have found, however, that these kinds of randomly generated graphs don't seem to match very well the kinds of social network graphs that you see in practice in the real world.